Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to all Dinarans on the go and in the know, wherever you may be, November 1st, 2019. No hype, no BS, just the facts. Hit the like and subscribe buttons so you don't miss out on my next post. I encourage you, knowledge is power, stay informed and stay alert, and know that today, we are one day closer than yesterday. First article of interest. Washington announces its position on the demonstrations in Iraq and criticizes the government investigation. November 1, 2019, 2147, Baghdad. The United States announced its position on popular demonstrations in Iraq since last month against corruption and the political system. U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo said in a statement, "The United States welcomes any serious efforts by the Iraqi government to address the continuing problems in Iraqi society. The situation closely, we have called since the beginning of all parties to renounce violence," he added, "like the investigation conducted by the Iraqi government in the violence in early October to sufficient credibility and deserves the Iraqi people accountability and justice real." He pompeyed that with the commencement of efforts announced by President al-Mousily, must ease the severe restrictions recently imposed on the press and freedom of expression. Freedom of the press is an integral part of democratic reform. The U.S. government continues to support the Iraqi institutions and people in the security, stability and sovereignty of Iraq, he said. Next article of interest. Legal experts send a letter to the United Nations on the suppression of demonstrations. November 1, 2019, Baghdad/Al-Khbar. Experts in the field of Al-Qaeda sent a letter to the representative of the UN Secretary General Heinz Blachart on the demonstrations and the responsibility of the International Organization in Human Rights and defending freedom of expression. The experts said in the letter received by the news, "Ms. Heinz Blachart, representative of the Secretary General of the United Nations, respected, greetings and respect. The human values of the civilized world and the defense of human rights are fundamental to the preservation of human dignity. This principle has been affirmed through international conventions, including the 1945 Charter of the United Nations. The preamble of the Charter is stated, and Article I, Paragraph II, and Articles 55.56 and other legal texts. 3. The Charter states that human rights are not an absolute competence of governments and cannot act at will. 4. Yes, human rights have been violated in Iraq. Yes, it mimics the world that this great people, by its originality and the immortal legacy and sacrifices, will not accept humiliation and will not accept a reckless system of values that is irrelevant to the great principles of the Fradian people. 5. The lawyers of Iraq with a great history and campaign of the right message to the courts of justice, on the basis of international and constitutional foundations for the protection of human rights, on the premise that humanity is a civilization and justice and fairness and peace can only be achieved by achieving justice and preserving human dignity. From this standpoint, in the name of humanity, in the name of the Iraqi people, in the name of the youth and all the people who are protesting, and fulfill their legitimate demands, which are the demands of all the Iraqi people, and take decisions to hold accountable those responsible for the bloodshed of our people, in accordance with international criminal law, respect the will of the people and their choices in defining a democratic system of government. We also ask the United Nations to take legal action in accordance with the Charter of the United Nations to prevent any international or regional body from interfering in the affairs of our country. We conclude this opportunity to send a greeting and respect from the people of the Euphrates and the lawyers of the Tigris and Euphrates. You and all the benevolent in the world with deep respect and appreciation of the lawyers of Iraq, about them." Next article of interest. Legal expert, Abdul Mahdi can be questioned in absentia according to the institution. January 11, 2019, 1:55 p.m. Orbit Agency Agded, Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi could be questioned in absentia according to the Constitution and bylaws of Parliament, legal expert Ali Al-Tamimi said on Friday. Al-Tamimi said in a press statement singled out by the RBIT that F notified to be questioned and did not attend yet did not provide excuse his draft can be held accountable and questioned in absentia, pointing out that he reason is considered to have waived his rights stipulated in the Constitution and the rules of procedure of Parliament. He added, "Parliament control of the executive authority was absolute without restriction in Article 16 of the Constitution and the rules of procedure of the Parliament, as the difficult circumstance experienced by the country requires the presence of the Prime Minister run to the Parliament, but the lack of attendance indicates indifference and waive the constitutional right, explaining the interrogation is a parliamentary political investigation applicable to the general criminal rules in the absence of the text. He pointed out that the Eagle rules say ward off evil first of bringing benefits, and if conflicting interests took into account the greatest harm to the lighter, and know the most severe harm lighter, stressing that the public interest requires in absentia interrogation. He pointed out that even if Abdul Mahdi did not attend and remain in the government, the prosecution of international prosecution, even if after a while because the killings of demonstrators do not fall statute of limitations as happened to the Chilean president, who was tried internationally in a wheelchair after retirement. Next article of interest. Ameri is holding dialogues with the leaders of the blocs to discuss the replacement of Abdul Mahdi. 1 November, 2019 Baghdad, MP for the Conquest of the Alliance, Amr Fayez, on Friday, that the leader of the coalition Hadi al-Amiri is holding dialogues with leaders of political blocs to discuss the replacement of Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi, Al-Fayez says, in a statement reported by the New Arab newspaper and seen by Magazine News, that dialogues conducted by the head of the coalition, Hadi al-Amiri, with a number of leaders of the blocs to discuss the file to replace Abdul Mahdi and the crisis will result in the absence of resignation, he added. The majority of political blocs are not sticking to it, but the talk now is about the alternative character and how can be chosen and agreed, stressing that of course there is no Shiite objection to the replacement of Abdul Mahdi. Next article of interest. Soleimani vows to suppress the Iraqi revolution and the rebels declare the challenge to mobilize around Tahrir Square. Thursday, October 31, 2019 Baghdad writings. Arab media say Iran has given instructions to crack down on protesters and rebels in Iraq in any way. Qasem Soleimani, commander of the Iranian Revolutionary Guards Quds force and the head of the Iranian expansion file in Arab countries, chaired a security meeting in place of Iraqi Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi to stop protests in Iraq since the beginning of October. Soleimani pledged during the meeting to use all the means to suppress the Iranian-style demonstrations in dealing with the protests. Despite the arrival of security support in the vicinity of the bridge in the Republic of Sindh, the arrival of demonstrators and rebels and the presence of unprecedented crowds in Tahrir Square in the capital Baghdad and its surroundings still persist in their demands to overthrow the regime, especially after the Iraqis united on the demand and the elements of security forces joined the ranks of the demonstrators, stressing that they have nothing to do. They fired continuous bullets at the protesters. Next article of interest. The rebels are demanding the return of Iraq to the Iraqis, and Sistani rejects the tutelage of foreigners on the country. Friday, November 1, 2019 Baghdad, writings. Rebels in Iraq continued their organizational innovations for a million on Friday, November 1, 2019. Footage from the heart of Tahrir Square in downtown Baghdad showed thousands of people from all regions joining the million-strong demonstration called by the rebels to assert their 20 demands, notably the overthrow of the regime and accountability for corruption, along with the growing anger among Iraqis against Iran and its continued control of the Iraqi decision and its support for armed militias to target protesters since the movement began on October 1, Iraq's top Shiite cleric, Grand Ayatollah Ali al-Sistani, has refused to impose any foreign opinion on Iraqis. Meanwhile, from the headquarters of the Turkish restaurant, which has become a symbol of the revolution in Baghdad's Tahrir Square, young protesters chanted for the revolution, expressing their main demand for Iraqis, which was as follows: our demand, our case, we want a homeland, we want a homeland, we want a homeland, our youth, our dreams, we want a homeland, return us Iraq. Next article of interest. Sistani, no regional or international body can impose what it wants on the Iraqis. 1 November, 2019 Baghdad, religious cleric Ali al-Sistani refused to intervene regional or international parties on the Iraqi issue or confiscate the will of Iraqis, respecting the will of the Iraqis to determine the political and administrative system of their country through the referendum on the constitution and the periodic elections to the House of Representatives is the principle that the religious authority has committed to and emphasized since the change of the previous regime, Sistani said in a statement. He added, today confirms that reform is an imperative necessity, as has been talked about more than once, but the necessary reform and must be carried out in this regard is also entrusted to the selection of the Iraqi people in all its spectrums and colors from the country to the extreme, and not to any person or a group or party with a certain orientation or any regional or international party to confiscate the will of the Iraqis and impose their opinion on them. We appeal to all parties to reflect on the present and future of Iraq and do not prevent them from passing emotions or special interests from taking the right decision in this regard, which is in the best interest of this country and its prosperity, he said. Next article of interest. Secret meeting between Revolutionary Guards chief and Baghdad lawmaker seen as a sign of Tehran growing influence in region. 1. November 2019, 9:56 a.m. Baghdad, Iran is working to prevent the ouster of Iraqi Prime Minister Abdul Mahdi, whose rule is threatened by the widespread anti-government protests that show no signs of slowing. The Reuters news agency reported Thursday, Abdul Mahdi expressed willingness to step down as part of possible reforms designed to appease anti-corruption activists, headed by populist cleric Muqtada Sadr. Sadr had been pushing for various militia groups and alliances to join forces and push Abdul Mahdi from office. On Wednesday, the head of the Revolutionary Guard Foreign Wing General Qasim Soleimani flew to Baghdad for secret meetings aimed at intervening on behalf of Abdul Mahdi, Reuters reported. According to the report, Soleimani asked Hadi Al-Amiri, Sadr rival and leader of an alliance of Iran-backed militias, to back Abdul Mahdi despite his decreasing popularity. There was no comment from Amiri or Sadr, but an Iranian security official told Reuters that Soleimani traveled to Baghdad on Wednesday to give advice to the Iraqi leader. Iraq security is important for us and we have helped them in the past. The head of our Quds force travels to Iraq and other regional countries regularly, particularly when our allies ask for our help, the unnamed official was quoted as saying. The arrival of Soleimani, the head of Iran elite Quds force and the architect of its regional security apparatus, signaled Tehran concern over the protests, which had erupted across the capital and in Iraq's Shiite heartland, and included calls for Iran to stop meddling in the country. Reuters noted that while Iranian officials, including Soleimani, have close ties to the Iraqi government, the general direct intervention in an internal political issue was a sign of Iran growing influence in the region. Israel has accused Iran of seeking to place advanced weaponry in Iraq that could be used to target the Jewish state. The U.S. envoy for Iran Brian Hook said Thursday that Tehran has funded militia groups in Syria and Iraq to the tune of $16 billion. The protests in Iraq are fueled by local grievances and mainly directed at political elites, but they also pose a challenge to Iran, which closely backs Abdul Mahdi government as well as powerful armed groups in the country. An increasingly violent crackdown in Iraq has raised fears of a backlash by Iran and its allies. The day after the protests erupted earlier in October, Soleimani flew to Baghdad where he surprised a group of top security officials by chairing a secret meeting in place of the prime minister. We in Iran know how to deal with protests, Soleimani told the Iraqi officials, according to two senior officials familiar with the meeting who spoke on condition of anonymity. This happened in Iran and we got it under control. But nearly a month later, the protests in Iraq have resumed and demonstrations continue in Lebanon, both directed at governments and factions aligned with Tehran. The protests threaten Iran regional influence at a time when it is struggling under crippling U.S. sanctions. The day after Soleimani visit, the clashes between the protesters and security forces in Iraq became far more violent, with the death toll soaring past 100 as unidentified snipers shot demonstrators in the head and chest. Nearly 150 protesters were killed in less than a week. Overnight Tuesday, masked men who appeared to be linked to Iraq security forces opened fire on protesters in Karbala, a holy city associated with the martyrdom of one of the most revered figures in Shiite Islam. At least 18 protesters were killed and hundreds were wounded in bloodshed that could mark an ominous turning point in the demonstrations. In Baghdad, protesters burned an Iranian flag. Days earlier, protesters had gathered outside the Iranian consulate in Karbala, chanting "Iran, out, out." Iran has been largely silent on the protests until Wednesday, when Supreme Leader Ayatollah Ali Khamenei accused the U.S. and its regional allies of fomenting the Iraq and Lebanon unrest. According to his website, Khamenei, speaking at Iran Air Defense Academy, was quoted as saying that U.S. and Western intelligence services are making chaos in the region. He urged Iraq and Lebanon to prioritize national security and respect for law while also saying the protesters' demands are right. More articles of interest to come. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and the alert bell so you don't miss my next post. I encourage you, knowledge is power, stay informed and stay alert. Over and out for now, the Dinarian.